Okay, we got a big weekend on tap, a couple of big football games here, and Bruce was telling us before the show, we've got some serious rain ahead in the next couple of days.
That's right. I don't think it's going to be too bad for most of the weekend, but at the tail end, that's when we really need to start paying attention to the forecast and to the weather, and I'll explain why that is in just a minute. But first, let's take a look outside right now, a live look outside in Beaverton. You know, 45 degrees, the current temperature. Our temperatures really haven't budged much as we've gone through the evening tonight. So we topped out, you know, low 50s, and we're kind of just dropping a few degrees. And right now we're still 49 in Portland. You've seen some decent showers blow past over the Coast Range. They've gone mainly north, but we're going to see increasing showers come our way in the morning right over the top of us, and then we'll see the rain more significantly come in from the west. Now, we've got a couple of big events tomorrow, football related. First, we've got game day in the morning down in Eugene. I would bring a slicker if I were you. I'm going to show you raincast in a minute. It looks like the rain holds off until all the game day happenings early in the morning. But sometimes that stuff shows up early, and I don't want you caught without that. As far as the kickoff for tomorrow night's game versus Stanford, it just looks like a chance of shower. So we may yet again get away without rain at Autzen, which is exciting. Now, the Beaver game's a little later versus Cal. It's going to be around 7:30 for kickoff. I think we'll see a shower or two, but again, it looks like most of the game is dry, and that's pretty amazing considering what's coming our way. First thing in the morning, little pieces of this system going to get pulled up into our sky, so we may get some leftovers from this thing first, and San Francisco's been getting hammered by this. That's where most of the rain from that one stays. This is our main rainmaker for our Saturday, and you can see it's got a nice development here to the cold front. Back behind it is cooler air, but this moves across our skies and brings some breezy winds to the valley and gusty winds to the coast, but this is just the warm-up for the real system, the heavy hitter that comes in later in the weekend. Here's 7 a.m. tomorrow morning. So we got, you know, game day going on in Eugene, and it looks dry right now, but the rain is so close. And by 9, 10 a.m., most of us are seeing rain. And briefly, notice right down the back of the cold front right there, that's where you get the heaviest rain. When that thing comes in, we may get a quick burst of wind and also a downpour, but it doesn't last too long. Here's 1:30 in the afternoon, and many places in the valley are beginning to dry out. And you notice snow showers for a time, too, over the Cascades if you're driving the mountains there tomorrow night. Then let's look at this. This is Sunday. This is when we really get soaked, and watch the rain continue Sunday night into Monday now, and we're just under the gun. I want to show you by the rain totals adding up. At first, it's not so much through Sunday night, maybe a quarter inch, no big deal. But Sunday night into Tuesday, into Monday night rather, so a 24-hour stretch, and our totals are off the charts. This could mean some flooding issues, at least localized. And you know the usual things that go along with that, say in the Coast Range, for example, the slides. And we're going to have some gusty winds with that too. So that's a lot to watch. So briefly on Saturday, it's wet, but it doesn't really turn very wet for us until Sunday evening. It's the winds that I'm concerned about for Sunday night and Monday as well. We'll have hurricane force gusts along the coast and easily 35-mile-an-hour gusts inland. That combined with all the rain, you know what that means, right? Some scattered power outages at least. So here's your weekend coast. Storm watching this weekend. Big waves already hitting there as well. Rain at times through the gorge, so driving through there, not a problem, except it's going to be wet. For the Cascades, morning rain tomorrow, then afternoon snow, and we reverse that on Sunday. And central and eastern Oregon, you'll see, you know, rain and snow showers, but I think the heaviest moisture is actually going to be on the west side of the state. So there's a 7-day forecast, and let me tell you, it looks just soggy now through Thanksgiving. It is just amazing how much rain we're going to get. Sunday into late Monday or early Tuesday, though, that's the time where we really need to be watching, and I bet weather's going to be a significant story for us come early next week.
And that heavy rain as we move into Sunday night.
That's right, and then the winds pick up overnight and into Monday.
All right, Bruce, thank you.
Thank you, Bruce. Okey-doke.